Hello, today we're going to build two devices. One is a gateway, LoRa, and the other one is a LoRa node, and that will communicate to each other. I used some PCB Way boards that I built myself, and then I used an ESP32, two connectors for antenna, an RF M95, and some other connectors with the antenna as well. So what we're going to show you is how to build this one very quickly. You just need some training on how to solder components. It's very easy. And as you can see on the picture, I started soldering the ESP32 on the PCB Way board. The PCB Way board can be ordered directly on PCB Way. I will leave the link in the video. And you start soldering all these components, being sure that the soldering is done correctly without any issues. After you sold the board, which will take you like a few minutes, you will see that the Arduino ESP is well positioned. And after that, what I would do is I would start soldering the I would remove the Arduino ESP and start soldering the RFM95 chip on the board. That's a little bit more tricky to do, because you need to position it correctly with all the pins at the right thing, and then at the beginning it may move. So the first thing I would do is I would solder one pin to be sure that everything that the position is correct, and after that I would go on and soldering the other pins. This may take another 2 or 3 minutes, maybe 5, depending on your experience in soldering. After you've done that, you almost finished the work to do. The board now looks quite neat, very very easy, and the last thing to do is to solder the connector of the antenna. And this is also quite easy to do. You just plug the connector. You have to buy the connector and plug it in, at the position of where the soldering units are, and then you start soldering those components as well. That is the end of the soldering part. And now, after that's finished, you can look at the board, and it's very very nice and steady and ready to be programmed. So what you would do now is we plug in back the ESP32. Actually, we have to do first the second unit, so you have to have two units done at the same way. So because one will be the transmitter, the other one will be the gateway, and then you plug in the ESP32 on both of them, and then plug the antenna. As you can see on this video, it's going to be quite nice and looks pretty cool as the beginning. So it's very very easy to do. So it takes just like 10 minutes to build up this one. What you need to do now is to start programming the first board, which in my case will be the gateway, the ESP32 gateway. So I launched the Arduino IDE, and the first thing I do is I check if the ESP32 hardware devices is loaded. In my case, it's already loaded, but if it's not loaded, you just follow the instructions on the internet on how to load the ESP32 hardware devices on your Arduino IDE. Then I check, I select the correct hardware. So in my case is the Arduino ESP device node, and then development node, and then you have to select the port. After that is done, you need to load the library LoRaNow. And this library, you just have to open the library section of the IDE, and you search by LoRaNow, just like you see on the video. Once you get the LoRaNow library, which should not be installed. You install it easily, very easily. You wait until the library is installed on the IDE. And once that is done, we can go to the examples and start getting our gateway loaded and modified. After you loaded the library into the IDE, what we need to do is to go into the example section of the LoRaNow and to select the first example that we want to load into our ESP32. So in this section you find a lot of files. We select the LoRaNow gateway ESP32. Opening that example, we need to modify it in order to be compatible with what we want to do. First thing we want to do is to put the SSID information and the password. This means this will allow you ESP to connect to your local network and internet as well. Then what you need to do is to uncomment the frequency plan that you want to use. In my case, it's the 868 MHz for Europe. And then the last thing you want to do is to configure or set the pin configuration of the ESP32 with the RFM95. As you can see, the first pin is the SCK, which is connected to the D18. So we put 18 on the first part of that library. Then we select the MISO, which is pin 19, so we put 19. MOSI, which in my case it's D23, so we put 23 there. And then the SS, which on the schematics is the NSS, which is on pin 5, put 5. And then at the last one is the DIO0, which in my case is D2, so you put 2 there. Now if you don't use PCB Way, you can do your own schematics as you want, but just follow this way of configuring it. Once that is done, what you need to do now is to compile it and to load it onto the ESP32. You will see now that it's just compiling and loading. I also opened the monitor just to check that once the software is loaded on the ESP, all the communication with the monitor is correct, and we can get some messages which will help us to do the next section. Now the software is compiled and it's now loading into the board, so everything seems to be okay, as you can see. After that, the board on the monitor side starts communicating, and you will see that it's communicating with my SSID, and it has an IP address. You just have to now record that IP address, paste it on a web browser, and you will see that there is this screen coming out on your web browser. So it means that the ESP is actually using a web browser to communicate externally. Once that is done, your first part of the project is finished. And what you need to do is you need to disconnect the gateway from the PC and plug it on a normal power in your house, so that it automatically connects on the Wi-Fi without any trouble. And this, you leave it there for the moment, so this will connect to the internet. Then you get your second device, which you have built in the meantime, and you plug it in so that we can load the software of the node that will be connecting to the gateway. So now we go back to the examples and we select the LoRaNow ESP32 node. So in this case, what you need to do is still to modify, you need to select the frequency, so you need to uncomment the frequency plan that you want to use, and then you still need to put the same connections of the RFM95. So it's 18, 19, 23, 5, and then 2. Don't forget to uncomment this function, otherwise it won't work. After you've done that, you load the application to your node, so it's a second device that you have, and this will start compiling and eventually loading the software. So it's a quick completion. It's now loading, and as a first thing, you will see on the monitor that it's sending messages. In some cases, it's sending messages. Now, how do you see if the message is received by the gateway? Very simple. You have the other board, which is connected on power supply. So what you do is you open again your browser, and you refresh the browser, and then you start seeing that there is a loading. The node is sending messages to the browser. So this means that the two components, the two LoRa devices, are communicating. One is receiving and the other one is sending. And just to be sure that our node is the one that is communicating, what I wanted to show you here is that we could change also the message. So the message that is sent is LoRaNow node message. What we can add there is LoRaNow load message, and we can add just something to make it unique so that you know that that's the one it's doing. So what I did is I added on LoRaNow message so LoRaNow JFF message equal, and then I compile it and I send it to the node again. So that takes a while, and then when it starts again, after it's compiled and is sent to the node, the device starts sending again the message, and you can see now that the message is now LoRa, now JFF message. I hope you enjoyed the video, and thank you for your attention. Bye-bye.